On to some other news now. 3 days after the Nankana Sahib Gurudwara was vandalized by a mob in Pakistan, more arrests have followed. The police have named 55 persons and are examining their role in the stone pelting incident at one of the holiest Sikh shrines. Now, this action comes after India registered its strong protest over the attack and demanded the culprits be brought to book. Now, this is the Nankana Sahib Gurudwara in Pakistan's Punjab province, one of the holiest Sikh shrines where the first Guru of the Sikhs, Guru Nanak, was born. 3 days ago, this religious place of the Sikhs was vandalized by a group of local Muslims. Tension sparked after a Muslim man abducted and later converted a Sikh girl. The girl's father serves as the Panthi at the Gurudwara. Police registered an FIR in relation to the Gurudwara attack on Sunday. Now they have identified 55 persons whose role in the attack is being probed. Pakistan government has denied reports of the Gurudwara being vandalized. They claim the dispute broke out between the two families. The FIR registered at Nankana police station also includes provisions under the Anti-Terrorism Act. Action is finally being taken 72 hours after the incident, and India on day one had strongly condemned this vandalism. The Indian External Affairs Ministry called upon Pakistan to take immediate steps to ensure the safety, security and well-being of the Sikh community. Indian politicians from across the political spectrum, including Congress MP Rahul Gandhi and Union Minister Harsimrat Badal, termed the incident shameful. They appealed the neighbouring nation for immediate action. Chief Minister of Indian State of Punjab, Captain Amrinder Singh, appealed to the Pakistan Prime Minister to immediately intervene and ensure that the devotees stranded in Gurudwara Nankana Sahib are rescued. There is pressure on Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan to act. Indian government has also found a reason to point fingers at Pakistan's ill-treatment towards Sikhs, a minority community in Pakistan. India recently amended its citizenship law to grant citizenship to Sikhs facing religious prosecution in Pakistan. Just 2 months ago, Pakistan rolled out the red carpet for the Sikhs with the inauguration of the Kartarpur corridor. The corridor facilitated access between two major Sikh shrines, Gurudwara Darbar Sahib in Pakistan and Dera Baba Nanak Shrine in India. After the Nankana Sahib attack, Sikhs in India have openly appealed to Pakistan Prime Minister to secure the interest of Sikh community in Pakistan. The registration of the FIR is just one step as Pakistan faces the big task of bringing the culprits to book. Chief Anas Malik now joins us live from Islamabad. Well, Anas, first of all, if you can give a brief of what are the updates in the case.
Well, Nishita, last night we saw the arrest of Imran Ali Chishti, the main culprit behind this Nankana Sahib incident, who had orchestrated and instigated that mob that had vandalized, pelted stone and surrounded the Gurudwara Nankana Sahib. Now, we saw that 3 days later, we saw the arrest of Imran Ali Chishti under six sections of the Pakistan Penal Code. That includes Article the imposition of Section 295A with regards to demeaning religious scriptures and hurling slurs on with regards to one's religious beliefs. Secondly, he was also booked under the 780A, that is a non-bailable offence under the Anti-Terrorism Act. Now, today in the morning, the officials told Vyond that another 55 people have been booked as well. Those who have been booked, they were part of the mob that was involved in vandalizing the Gurudwara Nankana Sahib on Friday. The DC Nankana Sahib told us that the deputy commissioner told us that the process of identification of these miscreants or those individuals within the mob is currently underway with through video footages, and that they would soon be brought to justice. They are in touch with the Pakistani database authorities and other authorities to identify these miscreants, to identify these individuals who have been part of the mob. Now, something that is really interesting is the fact that how the Pakistani administration that has been in denial with regards to this incident since day one is now going on and arresting those who have been involved. We saw the press conference from the Pakistani Interior Minister yesterday as well. We saw some key visits with regards to Muslim scholars and scholars from other faiths as well. visiting the Gurudwara Nankana Sahib yesterday and day before as well. But on part of the government, they had been in a complete denial, and they had been terming this incident as a clash between two Muslim groups. So the question here arises is if Pakistani government is to be believed, that if at all there was a clash between two Muslim groups, then why this person is being arrested? If you are arresting somebody, then at least be honest for the fact that there was indeed an act of vandalism, instead of clearly going out and rejecting such reports, contrary to what the evidence suggests. And the evidence is very clear that yes, there was an instigated violence, there was a mob violence that had surrounded the Gurudwara, that had pelted stones, and Pakistani government cannot just turn a blind eye towards it. Now the second challenge towards the Pakistani government remains is to ensure swift justice, to ensure that those who had been involved in this heinous crime are brought to task, and not just the registration of FIRs or they being put behind bars, but the fact that justice should be ensured, a court trial is to follow, and that those who have been involved in heinous crime should be taken to task as per law. Yes, right, Nishita.
Thank you, Anas, for joining us with all those details.